Alex, you've had such a long career, and it's pretty fun for me personally because I've watched you obviously up north playing hockey and at the U, but I'm curious about your play yourself. Like when I was watching you at the U, the way that you move along the blue line, the way we call it walk the line, head up, pump fake, is something that always jumped out to me. Does that just come natural? Or how are you able to even elevate that even more as you're still doing it here like 15 years later?
Yeah, I mean, I think some of it's probably natural. It's obviously stuff you work on too as you grow up and everything. But you know, I think as you get older too, paying attention to your body, you know, make movements like that and skate like that. You know, you gotta have good hips, and you know, I do a lot of Pilates and yoga in the summers, and that helps with staying limber and being able to be smooth on my edges and stuff like that. So, just staying on top of it.
You're such a pro, and you're so good at the little things. Like when you look back, like who are some of the guys that exemplified that, whether it's character or commitment to training and the little things in the locker room growing up for you when you first started pro and seeing that?
Yeah, thank you, first of all. I think definitely my first taste of pro hockey left a big impression on me, just the veteran guys we had there in Pittsburgh and the way they approached the game and the focus and the way they worked, and to be kind of immersed in that when you start your pro career, kind of, I think that can kind of set the tone for a player.
Well, why don't we open these things up?
All right.
Let's see. So in the Florida game, you guys have been just crushing it with a goalie pulled and being able to capitalize. And so this is a clip from in Florida, empty net, 4-2. You're on the ice.
Dumba holds his own. Rask for Goudreau. Goligoski wheels and fires. Save Bobrovsky. Rebound. They score!
I'd just be really curious to hear your mentality and your teammates on the ice in these closing moments of games.
Yeah, I probably haven't been on a team that's scored this many, 6-on-5 in bunches like this, but it's a great thing to be able to do and have that confidence if you're in that situation. It's tough. There's a lot of guys on the ice in a small space, so you want to try to find where there's going to be a little bit of space and create some chaos.
Great hands, a little spinorama, rip the puck on net.
Yeah, that was just good communication. Moose was on the weak side there going to the net, and he just gave me a quick yell, and I just tried to put the puck to a space where he could get a stick on it. So good communication helps everything.
One aspect of your game that also really stands out is your play away from the puck. And I don't think a lot of players or people recognize how challenging it is and how important it is to kind of gap up and use C cuts to manage your speed and almost mirror the forward. And so we're just going to take a look at you on a rush and how you defend that.
Yeah, Shifley picks the puck up. At this point, you know, I'm checking to see what's coming next. I see Freddie's in a good spot on the back check there, so this is what we call it here. We call it a squeeze. So if, you know, if there's a situation where we can get the forwards to kick a puck out wide, we want to try to really pressure them there because it's going to be really tough for them to make a play. So we're able to get the puck out of Shifley's hands with a good gap, and once that goes to the wall, that's kind of a green light for us defensemen to step up on our guys and have good sticks, and that's really everything. That's our read. So at that point, it's a 2-on-2 for us, and we can close on them quick and make it hard on them to create offense.
This next clip, in your guys' game against Dallas, Zuccarello scored a pretty sick goal, but it goes all the way back to the D zone, and I love this play. You read the play. You're so good away from the puck. And just kind of walk us through this breakout, because instead of, a lot of people think, hey, to score you got to go forward, but you recognized how to move forward and you moved laterally in order to give Rask an option to pass to.
Yeah, I mean, it just starts a great job by Spurge and Rasky in the D zone. You know, I'm kind of just hanging out with my guy there. We create the turnover. I think a lot of times with these guys in particular, they can play a little more cerebral game, you know, a little more east-west than some of our other lines. But yes, it was just kind of one of those plays, you know, I got to find some ice there and be an option for Rasky. And I have Kirill, who's already kind of in the spot I'm going to. So I'm just trying to find ice to be an outlet for Rasky. And, you know, it allows us to advance the puck.